measure pin, spice, lemon, too hard. Well, it tastes lemony and kind of like tea, like iced tea, and it's quite nice. Hi YouTube, my name is Diana and this is my first vlog called the Great British Bake Vlog, where I'm baking my way through the Great British Bake Off season one. If you've never seen the Great British Bake Off, it is a series of bakes, and sometimes the contestants know what they're baking and sometimes it is a surprise for them. So I'm going to take one bake on each episode. For this one, I've just chosen one of the bakes that they liked the most. For that one, it is a cake, and it is called, oh, it's got a bloody long name, Lemon Cake with Lemon Curd and Double Cream. So that's what we will be making. So let's get started. So you want to add your butter, which I'm a bit of a wank and did not take mine out of the freezer, so I had to grate it, which is very stupid. Another big difference is we do not weigh anything in Canada. We use cups, which after watching the show I've realized seems horribly inaccurate. So I'm going to weigh out 350 grams of caster sugar, which I had to make because we don't have caster sugar, which is very finely ground sugar. I don't know. Hopefully that's what it is, because that's what this is. Oh fuck, I don't have enough. Well, bloody hell. I'm gonna have to make some more caster sugar. Oh fuck, that's not sugar at all! That's my self-rising flour! Well, gee willikers. This vlog is obviously very family friendly. This is my caster sugar. We need 350 grams. It's bridged up like fertilizer. We need a spoon. Cream the butter and sugar together until pale and fluffy, just like myself. Counters are not made for people who are 5 feet tall. I don't know what size of people they're made for, but not me. Focus, focus. So that's what it looks like right now, which I don't think that is fluffy enough. So we're gonna fluff it up a bit. I've just realized that filming the Great British Bake Off must be the most boring job on the planet, because watching the show is quite riveting, but I'm realizing as I bake myself that it's not super interesting. Okay, so now I think that this is pale and fluffy. I don't know. It looks quite fluffy and quite pale to me. It's about a shade darker than my actual complexion. So, you know, that's reasonably pale and it looks fluffy-ish. No. So next we are going to add the zest of 4 lemons plus the juice of 2. And I have a microplaner from the dollar store, so this should only take about 7 hours. So because I'm a famous vlogger now, I really don't have the time to zest all of my own lemons. I'm just going to enjoy this Pim's and have my sous chef, Cody Creelman Calvet, if you want to follow his vlogs, zest 3 of the lemons, and then I'll fly in and do the 4th, like a proper professional. Quite smart, isn't it? So this is just candied peel that I made earlier. You just boil it in water and sugar for like 45 minutes and then dry it in the oven. Our kids were kind of the devil for the last 3 days, so this has dried out for a few days now, so I don't know if that's going to affect its efficacy, but concrete. Okay, so I'm gonna add my candied lemon and my lemon zest. I feel like this is going to taste super lemony. And my lemon juice. So we need the juice of 2 lemons. I keep thinking that like this is endorsed by the Great British Bake Off, so it will only be British people watching it. They called me up and were like, do you want to make a show that's like our show but way worse? And I was like, yes, I would love to do that. So I'm gonna beat in 6 Canadian eggs, 1 at a time. So now we need to add baking powder, self-raising flour, which I had no idea what that was. I had to Google it and then make it myself, which seems horribly impractical. And corn flour, which I thought was like polenta, but it is cornstarch. We call that cornstarch here.
Just measure them into a bowl.
Yeah, I know, but that's like from, like, I don't know. Looks a little sketchy. I think it's all a bit dirt going there.
I'm going to fold it in.
Better. It looks kind of like globuly, don't you think? The eggs made it look all.
I'm just gonna pop these in and hope for the best.
Set a timer for 18 minutes. She usually gives me a lot of sass when I tell her to set a timer. She usually says something like, "Oh, I can't wait to see what we're counting for." And I'm like, "It's time out, biznitch." Now we need to, while the cakes are cooking, make the lemon curd. Heat the butter, sugar, and lemon juice and zest in a bowl. Set over a pan of simmering water. What? Beat them in a, heat them. Yeah.
Oh, my lantern, this is so much work.
I should've got a lemon cake mix.
Okay, we need a pot of water and then probably a bunch of crap.
And then you just wanna like, I don't know. You know, let it all just mix together. And I'll be improvising in this recipe because later towards the end it calls for double cream. We don't have any of that kind of butter fat up in Canada. We've only got like, what's whipping cream? 28%? 30%? I don't want to open my oven. Did I not set a timer? Oh, I set it on my phone. Fuck. For the curd, you have to beat some eggs, two free range eggs. The cake, oh, bloody hell. My oven mitts are slightly shabby. I like shabby chic things. And they both got holes in them. I often actually burn my thumb on this one.
Is the left one actually for a right hand?
Yes, they both came like that. What do you think? Couple more minutes? Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think so too. Set a timer for 2 minutes.
We learned.
Definitely. That's done. We are just working on the Snapchat filter. We're just working on the lemon curd. It's so hot. My makeup's melting off my face. I'm so amazing. I can whisk with no hands. Very steamy. It's a very steamy scene. We need to fire that hand double. It's terrible.
So now we're gonna make the cream, which is whipped cream and icing sugar, I believe.
I think I got a little excited taking this one out to the pan, and I was a little rough with it. Whereas this one, I treated it like a lovely newborn child and it just flounced right out. This is the bad kid. And this is the good kid. Okay, so does this stick to the back of a spoon? Sort of. I'd say that's looking pretty good. I think the cream is still, or the curd, the lemon curd is still a touch warm, but I'm powering out, guys. I'm not gonna make it. Let's get this lemon curd on there. This is super tasty. I will probably make it again for my husband.
Now we're gonna put on a layer of whipped cream.
Semi-neatly get this on here. One hand over top. And I'm just gonna set that down. Got a little seepage, but I think it's okay. Yeah. Like a touch of seepage on the sides. Placing a little bit of cream on the sides, because hindsight, I wish I would have done a little bit more topping in the middle and had it kind of dripping out. And then typically the top would be topless scandal with just some icing sugar, but because I only use 2 pans and not 3, I'm just gonna put some topping on the top. Looking at this cake, it's probably gonna taste really good, but I'm not gonna lie, I feel like the presentation is like a touch on the shoddy side.
But it's a first, you know, like first go. So I'm pleased. I'm pleased with this cake. Now we're gonna taste this. I will put the link to this recipe in the down bar. You should make it. Wasn't too bad.
So thank you so much for baking with me today. Hopefully we will see you again. Cheerio.
Time for judgment. Do I have a bit of a Cockney accent? Would you say? My name is Henry Higgins and I'll be the judge today. This is a nice British lemon curd cake, just like my mum used to make back in Cockney.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
I feel like you're not a very good judge.
That's really good. It's very sweet.
It's very sweet. Do you think I did something to make it too sweet?
No. No, I missed my mouth.
Happens.
I would say you'd be able to go to the next round with this cake.
What if everyone else's cakes were better?
It's quite lovely. It's got a good bake to it. The curd, very tart. I think you could have whipped the cream a little more.
I agree.
It's not quite peaky enough. Did mommy make good cake? It's Scary Berry. Is your name Scary Berry? How's the bake on it?
Yay. Describe the bake.
Did it welcome? Whoa.
Oh,